I think that you mentioned this before too. The escape is always go to a place where you feel comfortable. Comfortable is usually operations and sales. Then maybe marketing, but IT and the numbers, I see the biggest resistance from business owners, especially numbers.
But I mean, I see some lawyers who like to hide out in IT. They like to hide out in marketing. It's just what they do. Some people hide out in HR. It's wherever they're the most comfortable, not where they're the most needed. And that's not everybody can be an entrepreneur. In fact, if you've got the chromosome or the genetic trait or the specific skill set to be an entrepreneur, it's not necessarily a good thing. People with that mindset, they are depressed in a corporate setting, but they got a good job and they don't want to let the family down. So they keep the job because family pressure says you don't quit a good job to go for a maybe. Because mm-hmm. the reality is, if you've got a corporate job and you're working 40 hours a week, and you got the insurance, you got the salary, maybe some bonuses. If you go out on your own and start your own business, even with a good, strong plan, you need to understand that you are trading a 40 hour a week job for a 60 to 80 hour a week job that's might pay nothing and it's certainly going to pay far less than you made at the previous job.
That's why it's the most rewarding. Yes.
If you still want to do it, I can work with you because that tells me you've got that entrepreneurial sickness that will give you the energy to push through having to sleep on the floor or maybe losing your house or your family or you know, eating ramen noodles for 6 months. But entrepreneurs do those things because they have a need and a desire to control and make an impact and do those things. But you can be taught to do those things, but
takes longer.
I talk to people who are like, yeah, I left my job to start my own company. Why? I want to be my own boss. I want the flexibility of being a business owner. I want to be able to take off on Fridays and pick my own kids up at the car line at 3 p.m. instead of having to sit in the office watching the clock till 5. I'm like, why do you believe you can do all these things? Well, my good friend who's owned her own business for 20 years, that's what she does now. I'm like, okay, but you're comparing your chapter one to their happily ever after.
Yeah.
I bet, I'm not a gambling man, but I bet that their first 6 months or 2 years in business did not involve taking off every Friday and leaving work early every day and
you have to
being their own boss and making enough money. I bet they could tell you some horror stories or some ridiculous heartache around the start and the formation of that business. And if you see that and you can honestly say you're prepared to accept that, then maybe you're an entrepreneur. But I've talked people out of it. I was like, you realize what this means, what you're doing. You're
going to business is not easy.
Still want to do it.
Business is not easy. It's hard. It's painful. It's going to be up and down. And it's a lonely road. You don't have anybody to share with. Again, that's how connecting with someone like yourself as a mentor, as a coach, you get to express yourself and put things in the right places and get out of that race much quicker. A lot of people never do that. And to them, entrepreneurship is working 80 hours a week because you have to, not because you want to. Yes, we work all the time as entrepreneurs, but it's a choice. It's just how we wired, right? So,
but having that outside voice, while I'm intimately involved in my clients, you know, financial reports, I'm intimately involved in their policies and their systems and procedures, I honestly don't care at all about the drama and the weeds of the production of the work. I don't care. I don't even need to know how to do what you do. It's not important. I need to know what the results are and what we need to do to make those results.
Exactly.
And when someone says, you know, we meet once a week and 4 weeks in a row, they're complaining about a problem employee, I'll have to say things like, we're not allowed to complain about her because you should have fired her 4 weeks ago. This is you're getting 90 minutes to talk to me about strategy and tactical and what we're going to do and how we're going to grow and goals. And we're talking about some receptionist that just wants to wear a tank top every day and it looks unprofessional. Tell her, wear a tank top again and you're fired. And if she wears a tank top again, fire her. because your word is your bond and you said it, but we don't need to waste any more time talking about drama or, oh, one of the salesmen is dating one of the customer service people. It's like, so what? They both have KPIs. Are their KPIs being hit? Because if their KPIs being hit, I honestly don't care what they do to each other, positive or negative, because this is a business. We are trying to meet goals and hit objectives. And if we're spending too much time on stuff that's either counter to that or not in furtherance of that, you need a partner to tell you to get your head out of the sand and stop worrying about these things that you could have fixed and you're not fixing it. Yeah, my nephew works at the firm and he's always late. And the other people are complaining because if they're late, they get written up. Well, fire your nephew. That's easy. I don't know him. I don't know the whole story about how his mom helped you. It doesn't matter. This is a business.
That's why somebody from outside needs to point this out, because they're too close and too emotionally attached. It's hard to have that conversation. My nephew, how can I tell him this? What about my brother or sister or whoever?
Well, that's an argument against hiring family members. If you can't hold your family members accountable, they shouldn't be working for you, because someone's in charge. And if it's the employees that are in charge, their goals are not going to be the same as yours.
Yeah.
Their goals is more money for less work. Your goal might be similar, but it's not more money for less work for them. It's everybody can work more and make more, but this is a business. I treat it like buying a stock. I want to put money into it and more money comes out of it.
Yes, exactly.
That's what I want. I don't care what it does. It doesn't matter if it's, you know, because I did law firms and there were people who did immigration law. And I found that the people who did immigration law were emotionally connected to the practice. They would get emotionally protected, invested in their clients, which made them good at what they did, but
not financially.
Made it difficult to step back and treat it like a business, because we can help a whole lot more people with their immigration problems if we're profitable.